right, well, it's 80 degrees out here and about to storm. So I just pushed off. I don't have to push off. I don't have to not touch the water. What feet are in the water now, which is great. All right, I don't know where I'm going. There has been a little bit of thundering, so might shorten the trip a little bit, but we got a lot of pleasure boaters out, but not a lot of wind, so it might be nice, smooth, except for the wake. Hey, I got it and did not sit on my water bottle this time. That's a good sign. Get this thing lined up a little bit. Taking Skyla out today, the Vapor 10 foot. It's a fast boat, so if the storms start coming on, I'll have the ability to leave. And come home. Where should we go? I'll try Bridgman's. I've not been there yet. It's a little bit far. But you got that paddle backwards. Got my... The wind's blowing to me. Southeast. I don't know that I want to go to the west. We'll go out this way, see what we see. Boat wakes here. Every time I try to speed up, we get start to get super splashed. Maybe it's a slow paddle. Those were in view. Just had a bunch of mergansers go by. Right above us. tandem out with my wife for the last couple days and did a lot. Hadley let her do some photography work, and it was a brilliant 5 or 6 hours of paddling, but my triceps are killing me, which is weird because you pretty much pull in a paddle. You don't realize how much you push a paddle all at the same time. It's like everything's good but the triceps. All right, we're gonna go over to Cole Island, check out the lakes. We had some amazing, we saw, I don't know, 10 herons and 2 bald eagles, 3 or 4 osprey, and about 25 or 30 crows all on one little lake for after about 5 minutes. It felt like Jurassic Park. It's that opening scene of Jurassic Park when they visit the park in the first movie. It's almost otherworldly. So let's see if we can find a little of that today as well. Also deconstructed a shed today, turned a few hundred screws with a pair of pliers. So, for my energy issues, can absolutely be that. There. You start to see that openings in the island from here. We also ran into 2 geese that were like blocking the entrance of that lake. It's kind of funny. So I pose a question and what I think the answer is, but somebody actually knows the answer, it'd be great to know. Every time we run into a pair of geese that we believe are nesting, one of them flies off and hangs out in front of us. No matter which direction we go, it stays in front of us. It seems to almost try to get in the way. So your space opens up and you truly just turn away from it. And we speculate that it's probably the male trying to offer itself as a target to get you away from the female and the eggs. But we don't know. So if you do know, please share in the comments. Outside of your view. That's the entrance to the first one. The other one's about 100 yards further. Also, the heron nests are down there. We'll try to let you see a heron on the nest. We had a really good shot of them 2 days ago. Got a picture of herons just sitting up on nests. It's a crazy looking thing. I'll put a photo of that at the end, maybe, of the video. Unless we get like the perfect shot here. Okay, let's see. Hiking on a little water. This seems to be okay. Okay, we're back. Tried to clean the lens. Hopefully I didn't like make it more dirty. I can't really tell from there. Okay, these pine trees to the left over there is where the heron nests are. It's a whole brood. It's a bunch of nests in there. We looked at it in the past, but we didn't really get a good view. So let's take another shot at it. And then right past that is our entrance to the second lake. Or lagoon, I should say, probably. Go through a wand here. Kill the wide angle and get a better view. Straight ahead. Oh, there's an osprey view here. He's over to my right. We're really not anywhere close to him. He's just sinking. Something that was big. I don't know what that was. Okay, so let's see if I can get in a position to see these. And then I'll aim the camera up there. Okay, there's a couple of them. Nobody's sitting though. Oh, there's one little guy sitting, maybe. Let's go right up here. Spin around. Oh, there's an osprey on this tree right here. Let's go back here for a second. and look up. You see that osprey right there? He's right above that. There he is. Right now, we're gonna tree up. Let's see if there's... You can see the chunky stick piles. And I've gotten too far down. You can't quite see if I paddle again. I guess I'll put the osprey back in here. As I go over there. Our video is not gonna have any birds in the nest, so we will put the picture of that from earlier a couple days ago. Uh-oh. What's going on? Is that on this side? I think that's clear. Let's go ahead and see what we see. Hopefully the water's high. And no ducks blocking the entrance, so that's cool. Now I hear herons, they're over there. Might can see him in the distance. Sound like the frogs croaking. Super active over there, like a bunch of them in the trees over there, but I'm not gonna see them. From here. Who knows what else is in here? But let's see. As a general rule, when you have good video footage coverage so you don't see anything, it's just the way it rolls. There's a few of those fish crows in here. There's crows. Oh, there's a bald eagle. There he is. Hopefully you see him. Very cool, huh? Alright, he's just flying over our head. Nope. Oh, what's that in the woods? Oh my god, that is a deer. Did you see that deer? This place is amazing. I thought it was a coyote there for a second. There's all these crows in here. Straight ahead's a few of them. They love these dead trees. Very, Edgar Allan Poe of them. Oh, I hear a lot of rumbling. Oh, there's a heron. Oh, two of them. Hopefully those are in view. I think they were. Let's just hang out a little longer. I don't know if you can hear that, but a lot of noise back there. A lot of move. Oh, here you go. Here's a heron coming into view. Flying over. Okay. This guy's making some noise. Probably am too far from home. For that level of thunder. Let's start our trip back. There's another two herons. Storm coming in, so we need to get our butts home. I'm sorry, that's gonna cut our trip short. It's supposed to get here quite this soon. I didn't go to Bridge Creek. That was about where the rain's falling right now. My head in here real quick. Bring the top up a little bit. Shrink it up a little bit. Get a better view of anything in front of us. The water's really high back here today. Ow, I still hit the sandbar. Silliness. Silly man. This is actually the one we saw the eagle in last time, I think. Well, I guess we saw one in both. That's what it was. Here's our view. Now we're gonna get out of here. I hear a lot of thunder coming. And there's gonna be some lightning in this storm eventually. Wasn't supposed to hit for another hour or so, but you know, the Northern Neck. So the Chesapeake Bay has its own mind. Alright, let's hop it off. Fit on this side. No, I'm dragging. All right, let's try to beat that storm. We'll hang out on the dock a little bit. We watch it come in. Oh wow, it just moved. In the wrong direction, it's moving. What is that? South to north? bad. We got the waves with us. He's got the power boats, he's heading home. Got a little bit better proposition than we do. Technically, we can walk from that blue house if we wanted to. Come back and get my kayak or something if I did. Alright, let's go. Lost my sun hood, that was cooking me. Osprey staying on his tray. Thought maybe they would go somewhere out of the storm. He's not gonna be happy, but I think I'm gonna cut between those poles. The thundery noises are coming from the Chesapeake. They're not coming from that thundercloud above us, but in front of us. Going to the right of us. Alright, cool. He flew, so I can get right between the dock and those posts. Chirping about it. You're not even over here. I don't think you have eggs yet. Alright. One more osprey nest and the third dock is ours. Now, osprey front fly, I missed that. All right, see the red roof of our barn? Almost there. Okay, I hear you. Moving on. All right, I need to take a sip of water here. I'm gone, bro. I came at me. Ever so slightly. Flew over my head, at least. Getting nasty. All right, made it back. By the way, I found this flag. American flag floating. Not even floating, buried under the rocks of that jetty right there. Had to pick a couple of them up to get it out. And it's a little dirty, you know. I guess you're supposed to get rid of flags that are dirty, but I don't know. It seems to be quite appropriate for our current moment in time. We have a lot of angst in our country, so, you know, I think it's still flying. Got a little dirt on it, a little tarnish maybe. It seems kind of apropos. I think it's going to stay. And we're back. I'll pick it up at the dock in a minute.